the global Chinese humanity.
And she conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we come to know the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, et in quidifica Iulum tutum meum. Iuri comete sentucene causa mente gente non santa, per nomine nene quando lo so adorne. Quae tuus Deus fortitudo mea, cor ne Christus, quae tristis in cielo, dum infligi me inimicus. Et mitte luce in tuum veritate, in tuum nisio de luce, non te luce, non te montum sanctum tuum, in tabernacula tua. Et in tuoi volontari Dei, et in quidifica Iulum tutum meum. Confite putibi in gitra, Deus, Deus meus, quae tristis anima mea, et quare tutum es me. Sver in Deo cor meta confitebo ibi, salutari mutus me, et Deus meus. Gloria Patri et Filio, et Spiritu et Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Et tuoi volontari Dei, et in quidifica Iulum tutum meum. Aut cor nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terra. Confitio Deum potenti, beata Maria, sempre Virgine, beata Maria, carica de gloria, te mea Baptista, sanctis postis praetur paro, mea tua lumbar, iubiane, unicus sancti, vobis fratres, quae perdonim mis constatione, verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed eo prego, beata Maria, sempre Virgine, beata Maria, carica de gloria, te mea Baptista, beata Maria, Baptista, sanctus postis praetur paro, mea tua lumbar, iubiane, unicus sanctus vos fratres, ora de comè, Domine Deum nostrum. Miseriato in tui, in tu tenis Deus, in mis peccatis tuis, perducente et vita eterna. Amen.
Confitio Deo omnipotenti, beati Maria sempre Virgini, beati Michaeli Arcangelo, beati Ioanni Battiste, Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paolo, omnibus Sanctis et Divi Pater, qui ab Calvinimis cogitatione, verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego, beata Maria, sempre Virgine, beata Michaelum Arcangelum, beata Ioanni Battista, Sanctus Apostolos Petrus Paulum, omnes Sanctos et Pater, orare pro me, ad Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miseriato vestri, nipotens Deus, et mis peccatis vestris, peducat vos in vita eterna. Amen. Lucens am assurcionem et remission, peccatorumus forum tribu, ad nobis omnipotens et misericus Dominus.
Amen.
Deus tu conversus vivifica vis nas.
Et plebs tua letabitur in te.
Ostendi nobis Domine misericordiam tuam.
Et salutare tuam da nebis.
Domine exaudi ratione meam.
Et clamor meus ad te veniat.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Orde. Cave venus justi et dominus exaudivi Deus, et ex omnibus tribulationibus eorum liberavi Deus. Benedicam Dominum in omni tempore, semper laus eus in ore meum. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Cave venus justi et dominus exaudivi Deus, et ex omnibus tribulationibus eorum liberavi Deus. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus boni voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. peccatus te, gratias agimus de ti propter magnum gloriam tuam, Domine Deus vece estis, Deus Pater omnipotens, Domine Filii unigenite Iesu Christe, Domine Deus omnius Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi miserere nobis, qui tollis peccatum mundi suscipe deprecationem nostram, qui sedis et extram Patris miserere nobis. Gloriam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum sanctus spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Pace vobis,
et cum spirito tuo.
Ordemus. Deus, qui nos concedi sanctorum matinum tuorum, Simforum sei et filiorum meus natalitia colere, dando vis in eterna beatitudine deorum societate gaudere. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesu Christum, Filium Tuum, videcum virta regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus. Acuntis nos caesus, Domine mentis in corporis, defende periculis, et intercedente beatri gloriosse, semper Virgine et Genetrice Maria, Cum beatu Iosef, beatis apostolis, tuis petrus, Paulus, quae beatis, cut manifur fili et omnibus sanctis, salutem nobis tribu et veninus et pacem, mutis fruxis, epices asicus, et eloribus universis, ecclesia tua securit, miseria et libertate. Ecclesia tua, caesimus, Domine, precius, peccatus, admite, mutis fruxis, epices asicus, et eloribus universis, securit, miseria et libertate. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivit et regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lex epistolae beati Pauli Apostoli et Hebreos, Frates, sancti per fidem vicerunt regna, operatis ob justitiam, et exis ob repromissiones, obdurabenunt ore leonem, extinguesserunt impetum ignis, et fugerunt acem gladii, Valuerunt de infirmitate, fortes fati sunt in bello, castra veterunt exterorum, acceperunt mulieris de resurrectione mortuos suos. Ali autem distensi sunt, non suscipentes redemptionem, ut meliorem in venerint resurrectionem. Ali verunt ibria et vebera experti in supere vincula et caceres. Lapidati sunt, setti sunt, tentati sunt, in uccisione gladii mortui sunt. Cicu erunt in melutis in pelibus caprinis, e gentes angustisati e fretti, quibus dignus non eret mundus, in solitudinibus erantes, in montibus et spelunces, et in cavernis terre, et hi omnes testimonio fidei probati, invensi sunt in Christo Iesu, Domino nostro.
Deo gratias.
Ecce quam modum et quam iucundum habitale fratres in unum, Sicut unguentum in capite quod discendit in barbam barbam arum. Alleluia, alleluia, hec est vera fraternitas, quae vicit mundi primina, Christum secuta est inclita tenens regna celestia. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo,
sequentia sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam,
gloria tibi Domine.
In illo tempore redicit Iesus discipulis suis, attendite a fermento phrasiorum, quod est sicur praesis, nil lautum opertum est quod non revelatur, neque absconditum quod non sciatur, quoniam quae in tenebris disistis in lumine dicetur, et quod in aurum locuti estis in cubiculis, predicabitur in tectis. Dico autem vobis amicis meis, neteri amini ab his qui occidunt corpus, et post hec non habet amplius quid faciant. Ostendam autem vobis quem temeatis, temite eum qui postquam occiderit, habet potestate miteri in gehennam. Ita dico vobis, hunc timete, noni quinque passeris venium depondio, et unus exilis non est in oblivione corrandeo, sed et capitis vestri omnes memorati sunt. Dolite ergo timere, multis passedibus pluris estis vos. Dico altim vobis, omnis qui cumque confessus fuerit me coram hominibus, et filius homines profitebitur ilam corum angelis Dei. Laus tibi
Christi.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us
sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast mass on this, the feast of Saint Symphorosa and her seven sons, martyred during the reign of Emperor Hadrian. Yes, the very same Hadrian who built Hadrian's Wall, whose reign began around 117 AD. So here we are at the beginning of the second century. To put things in context, the blessed apostles Peter and Paul have been martyred by now at Rome by 67 AD. St. Ignatius of Antioch had been martyred in 107 AD. And St. John the Evangelist, by now, had also passed away at Ephesus. So we are right at the beginning of the transition from the first generation, as it were, of the early church into the second generation, where we will have such luminaries as St. Polycarp of Smyrna, who also, with St. Ignatius, of course, have been taught by St. John the Evangelist. St. Ignatius, not yet dead. soon to be. So we're in the second century, beginning of the second century of the Church's existence. Now, of course, perhaps some of us forget the nature of the pagan religion of the Roman Empire. This particular testimony, this particular story concerning St. Symphorosa, and indeed her family, both her husband and her brother-in-law, had been martyred, concerns Hadrian and his new country palace, his new country villa. Now, as I said, the Romans were pagans. Anyone who's studied ancient civilizations perhaps will recognize this trait of them. We see the same practice among Aztecs, among Egyptians, and that was of sacrificing humans for the sake of a new structure, of a new building. Sometimes their remains would be put into the foundations. Sometimes their remains would be interred in the grounds that were of where the building would be. But the idea was, the pagan notion was, that the spirit, as it were, of these human sacrifices would strengthen their buildings. Hadrian desired human sacrifices for the building of his new country palace. Now remember, at this time, the church is still in persecution. She is not yet freed. She is not yet recognized. That wouldn't come until Constantine in the 300s. So it's a very treacherous time for Christians. And indeed, in Italy and around Rome, of course, Nero had blamed the Christians for the fire in Rome. And so that still lingered on in the minds of Romans themselves. Christians were not good things. Christians were regarded as treacherous, as treasonous, and as atheists, because they did not follow the state religion. In the Roman Empire, anyone who did not practice the state religion was thought of as an atheist. And only some other faiths were tolerated partly because of the Roman form of conquer. So they would allow some peoples to continue their faith practices, as, for example, they did with the Jews, until they felt that the Jewish rebellion was too much and they destroyed the temple in AD 70. So it was that Sensum Ferosa was known by the pagan priests to be a Christian. And now she herself too was pointed out by the pagan priests to meet a similar fate. She refused to burn incense before the pagan idols. This was the test by the Romans as to one's fidelity to the state, whether or not one would burn idols before the particular gods that the emperor had either adopted as his patrons, or indeed in some cases, like Caligula, had elected himself as a god. So to prove one's loyalty, one would be invited, if it was in question, to burn incense before the pagan idols. The Christians, of course, could not do this. Sensum Ferosa would not do this. And indeed, she argued with the tribune and with Hadrian himself, saying that she could not dishonour the memory of her husband and his brother and all her brothers and sisters in the Christian faith by doing such a thing. So it was that she was sentenced to death, and a few days later her seven sons were similarly sentenced to death, for they too would not recant of their faith, they too would not burn incense before the idols, and followed steadfast in the faith after their mother Simferosa. They, each of them, were martyred in a different way, one with a sword through his back, one cleft in half, completely brutally martyred. And their remains were thrown into a pit for the place where the emperor's palace would eventually be built. Subsequently, by the way, this place has been excavated. In our own time, my brothers and sisters, our own children are being asked and invited to sacrifice to idols now of the world's making. Perhaps there is no one yet central government akin to anything like the Roman Empire in terms of influence in its day, but rather there is the modern and contemporary zeitgeist, the modern way of thinking, contemporary ideologies that persuade and lean upon our children and our young people to worship them. We're all familiar, perhaps, with the television show Pop Idol. We know, of course, that the term idol is often used to refer to celebrities and superstars that often the young, particularly, follow and would love to become like. The prohibition by the Ten Commandments of God about idols was because, of course, they deflected worship and adoration and veneration away from Him, the true God. It is for this reason that Christians do not worship false idols. Thou shalt have no other God but Me. And we do, my brothers and sisters, in our contemporary age, idolize and thus make, as it were, of gods those whom we put upon pedestals, because the secularization, increasing secularization of the world has taken away the faith perspective, has taken away an appreciation of an objective morality, has taken away the notion of God. So that in the popular mindset now, instead of reserving our worship and veneration for God, having rejected God, contemporary society now worships, you know, nature abhors a vacuum, and so it is that now, as it, superstars, celebrities are themselves now the new gods of the present age. This is why, of course, there is so much consternation when these individuals are found to have failings. And when they fall from grace, they fall from grace quite considerably. More and more, it seems, these days, the notion or the phenomena of populism is fast becoming a kind of mob rule. So that the objective processes of perhaps elections are no longer respected. People go and protest because their side didn't win. And of course, there is no longer any objective moral code that most people would abide by. Instead, we have the rule of niceness. As long as you are nice to me, and I am nice to you, if I choose to be nice to you, then all's well and good. But don't you dare tell me what I can or cannot do. Don't you dare tell me what is right from wrong. Don't you dare tell me I have no right to anything. This is sadly the way most people think these days. As long as I'm left alone to do whatever I want to do, and as long as whatever you want to do doesn't, in my perception, negatively affect me, then that's okay. But also, you know, you have to like me, and you have to like what I do, and you have to like what I think. You're not allowed to disagree with me. You're not allowed to dislike what I think. You're not allowed really to have an opinion of your own that is in contrary, that is contrary to the popular opinion about anything. And so it is that aside from personalities like superstars and celebrities, so it is that other things have become idolized in our contemporary culture. Chief among them, I suppose, must be sex. Up there too, materialism. Our young people are sexualized from a very early age. There are two-part bikinis available for six-year-old girls, for goodness sake. Makeup is no longer, experimentation with makeup is no longer a teenage phenomenon, but a preteen phenomenon. The laxivity of morals and sexual mores in our present age means that even recently a teen magazine published a method of sexual intercourse that really is not healthy, is not suitable for preteens and young teenagers. People who have objected to that
have been called homophobic, when actually parents are rejecting or objecting to the suggestion that their children at such early ages and such tender ages should be practically encouraged to lose their innocence through experimentation and through articles which are not actually about education. But are promoting a notion of sexuality and sex without constraints. Our young people idolize material possessions. Everybody wants the latest phone, mobile phone. Everybody wants the latest laptop. Everyone went mad over those trigger things. Vapors, vaping, all these things. And children pester and pester their parents. And their parents generally give in, because their parents now are of a generation themselves that were spoiled, that were told they could have anything that they wanted, that they had a right to anything they wanted. And so we have generations now who demand, who have no notion of waiting for something, have no notion of working toward attaining something, generally. And if they have any ambition, it is only for more material gain. Is simply to become rich, to become powerful. And all of this, of course, is driven by vanity. All of it is driven by vanity. People are making idols of themselves, preoccupied with how they look and with what they possess, and how they look by and toward other people. Me, myself, and I. Look at me, fancy me. Look what I've got, be jealous of me. Me, 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 me. Contemporary zeitgeist makes idols of ourselves. And having done away with any sense of objective morality, and now everything is based upon subjective relativist perceptions of worth. So unless your opinion, or unless you are worth something to me, then you're not worth my interest. You're not worth my attention, you're not worth me caring about you or what you do, as long as it doesn't affect me. Whilst, my brothers and sisters, our children may not be threatened with being killed and buried for the foundations of new buildings, while we might not be being invited to burn incense before pagan idols, yet, my brothers and sisters, we are generally encouraged to advocate and condone this contemporary mindset of ego, of vanity, of self-obsession, of material possessions. And of course, as we have reflected before, this is the great tool, the favourite vice of the devil, is vanity, is pride. And this is why all the saints and the apostles and our Lord himself ever advocated us to practice humility, to practice humility. It takes effort. It doesn't come naturally to us on the whole, not for most of us. If we would practice the virtue of humility, we might more easily be able to love one another, we might more easily be able to help one another, we might more easily be able to help ourselves before God. Because being humble, we would be able to recognize our need for His grace, our need for His help and His assistance in our lives. We might, by being humble, acknowledge our faults and failings and receive that absolution that frees us from enslavery to sin and enables us to change and transform our lives. Myself and many other bishops fear that the time is coming of a great trial and tribulation for the church. It's already begun. It began last century. I'm firmly of that opinion. And it is insidious. We should be blessed, my brothers and sisters, to hope that we might suffer a martyrdom like our brothers and sisters in Egypt and in Syria and in Iraq and in other places of the world. We might bear glorious testimony to Christ and His body, the Church, and receive a tortuous but quick end. Receive a martyr's crown and enter into the joyful presence of our Lord. We should hope. But rather, my brothers and sisters, the martyrdom that we are likely to experience in the West is insidious because it comes by stealth. It's insidious because it comes through apostasy, through lack of faith. It's insidious because it appeals to self. And this is why, my brothers and sisters, in contrast to other places in the world, the church in the West is dying. Why? Because there is no sacrificial giving. There is no real expression of sacrificial love toward God. We give what we can. We give what we can when we feel like it. We certainly don't like to be told when we should give, let alone the idea we should be told what amount to give. We spare what we can when we can. That's why congregations are dwindling. That's why churches are requiring so much more expenditure and maintenance. Because for years, people have been putting in less than the widow's mite. Because they have been persuaded, because they have been consumed by the apostasy of vanity that is sadly our Western culture. For this to change, my brothers and sisters, we as Christians must start to live more sacrificially. We Western Christians must humble ourselves enough to recognize our faults and failings and receive God's forgiveness, and humble ourselves to seek to do His will. Humble ourselves to serve the poor. Humble ourselves to do what is objectively right. Humble ourselves to find the moral fibre within ourselves, to resist temptations, and to speak up for that objective morality which is Christ. To humble ourselves to pay more than just lip service to the tenets of our faith. Humble ourselves and attempt to be like that church described in the second chapter of Acts. A church that strived to meet daily, not just once a week on Sundays, but strive to come together daily, to pray together as a family, to eat together, to share together, according to need, what possessions they had, to witness together, to preach the gospel together, to serve the poor together. Fundamentally, to come together to worship God and to be with Him and with one another. I'm sure in your own heads now, you are going through all the usual excuses as to why that cannot be. We can't expect people to make such sacrifices anymore. And to which I ask, why? Why not? If we love God, are we putting God first when we say, I can't possibly meet any other time in the week than Sunday? Are we putting God first when we say, I have this to do and that to do, I haven't got time to say prayers, I haven't got time to go and help with the homeless? And the point is there, my brothers and sisters, it's not about giving up time, it's about making time. We all understand that people have to work. We all understand that there are certain constraints and responsibilities upon people's time, that they can't give time, but they can always make time. Strive to make time for God. This, my brothers and sisters, is the sickness in the church today. And the witness and the testimony and example of saints like Symphorosa and her sons is going for naught. Because we are unable to recognize apostasy that is within us. And yet, if only we would avail ourselves of the fullness of God's love, if only we would avail ourselves of the gifts of the Holy Ghost, if only we would avail ourselves, more than we do already, of those graces that God will grant us through His sacraments, through His church. If only we loved God more than ourselves. Only by doing so will we come ever to realize the fullness of our redemption in Him, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Ordemus.
Laetabni in Domino et exultate justi et gloriamini omnes recti corde.
Orate, fratres, ut me in vestum sacrificium acceptabili fita putem patrim omnipotentem, suscibi ad Dominus sacrificium in manus mentem, et laudem gloria nomis sui, et utilitate in proprio nostra transfacius per ecclesia sui sacra.
Terra mia secula seculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Sosum corda.
Habemus ad Dominum.
Gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Vere dignum et justum est Deo come salutare nos tibi sempre dubico et gratias agere Domine Sancti Pater omnipotens aeternae Deus. Per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem est statum tuum laudem angeli adorantem in nationes cel, tremunt potestatis celici annunque virtutes et beati serfim, socis ut actione congelibant, cunquibus de nostris vocis ut emitium est deprecamus supplici confessioni dicentes.
Sanctum, 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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis in celi aeterna gloria tua, hosanna in extensis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in extensis.
Thank you.
nobis quoque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordinibus precepti salutaribus moniti divinis nuntiale comati. Audemus dicere. Pater noster qui es in caelis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, et venia regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Se libera nostra mano. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Omnius Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, miserere nobis. Omnius Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, miserere nobis. Omnius Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, dona nobis pacem. Domine non sum dignus. Domine non sum dignus. Domine non sum dignus. Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi.
Domine non sum dignus, ut trespassum tectum meam, sed tantum de verbo, et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, ut trespassum tectum meam, sed tantum de verbo, et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, ut trespassum tectum meam, sed tantum de verbo, et senabitur anima
mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words for which you will find below your viewing screen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament.
I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Quicumque feceris voluntatem patris mei, qui in celis est, ipse meus frater et soror et mater est, dici Dominus. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Oremus. Resta nobis caesmus Domine, et ascendentibus sanctis matibus tuis, Symphoros figus eius, ut quod ore contingimus puremente capiamus. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordebus. Mundere mundia nos caesmus Domine divini sacramenti munus sublatum, et intercedente beate Virgine et genitrice Maria, cum beatu Iosef, beatis apostolis tuis Petrus, Paulus, quae beatis cum manitu et filii Dominus Sanctis, acuntis nos vetit professasissimus expiatus, et professasissimus expeditos. Caesimus Domine Deus nostre, ut quod divide tribuis participatione gardere, humanis non sinem secere periculis. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
et cum spiritu tuo.
Ite missa est.
Deo gratia.
In nomine Domini benedictum, ex obnunque dusque in saecula, auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terra, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus obiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem,
gloria tibi Domini.
In principio re verbum, et verbum eret acu Deum, et Deus eret verbum, hoc erat in principio acu Deum, omnium principium factum sum, sis in sum factum, sis nihil factum est. In ipsum vita erat, lux hominum, lux in tenebris, et luce in tenebris, non comprehenderunt. Quid omnium mystus Deo per nomine erat Ioannes, sic venit in testimonium, ut testimonium veperit lumine, et omnes credunt prium. Non in aquilis lux erat testimonium veperit lumine, erat lux vere, qua illuminat omnem hominem venientem in mundum. In mundo erat, mundus resum factus est, mundus in omnium vitae, proprii venitis sum non ceperunt. Quod quod ad tempus ceperunt, et de est molestatim filius Dei fieri, quis qui credit in nomine Eius, qui nolis sanguinibus, nec voluntati carnis, nec voluntati viris, lex Deo nati sunt. Et verbum caro factum est, et habitavit in nobis, et vinimus gloria, mens gloria, quos in genete et patri, per gratia veritatis.
Deo gratias.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray
for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Now, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray
for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Now, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this vale of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, who art our refuge and our strength, look down in mercy on thy people who cry to thee, and by the intercession of the glorious and blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and St. Joseph, her spouse, and thy blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and all thy saints, in mercy and goodness hear our prayers for the conversion of sinners and for the liberty and exaltation of our Holy Mother, the Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy Michael, Archangel,
defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast down to hell Satan and all wicked spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God,
have mercy upon me, a sinner.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God,
have mercy upon me, a sinner.
May our heavenly patron, Saints Catherine and Wilfrid,
pray for us.
May Saint Symphorosa and her seven sons,
pray for us.
May Saint Luina, Virgin Martyr of Sussex,
pray for us.
May Saint Richard, Confessor and Bishop of Chichester,
pray for us.
May Our Lady of Walsingham and all the angels and saints,
pray for us.